Today I'm introducing the Council's 10-year plan, a proposal to our community that looks at what our district needs over the next 10 years. Not all of our time and resources can be spent focusing solely on matters of survival. Some time has to be spent thinking about and providing life-enhancing qualities to our district.
3 years ago, Whangarei District Council was one of the first councils in the country to set a financial policy. The long-term plan for the next 10 years has set the parameters of total rate increases limited to local government cost index, which is currently at 3.52%, and we've kept debt levels for the 10 years at 161 million. Every year, new events occur like storm damage or changes in government legislation, which cause us to have to reassess position as part of the annual planning process. One of the main reasons we use debt is to share infrastructure costs across future generations. It would be unreasonable to expect today's ratepayers to meet all those costs for the future. Our debt levels are affordable and sustainable and are within the Local Government New Zealand guidelines.
The plan shows 79% spend on hard infrastructure, 21% on that soft infrastructure. We at all time try and balance the operation so people in all areas of the community get a benefit, and while some people don't see the spend on hard infrastructure as necessary as some of the niceties, we try to make sure that balance is very even. We're confident we can deliver this, and the spend we're proposing over the next 10 years is very, very similar to the spend we do today. So we're not going to be extravagant, but what we are going to do is follow very, very good practices of actually chasing subsidies wherever possible, and particularly in the two projects we're working on at the moment, the Lower Harbour Crossing and the road across Pauhi Island and the Ruakākā South Sewerage Upgrade. They both have attracted a dollar-for-dollar subsidy from the government.
Since 2006, we have responded to concerns about storm-related sewage spills into the harbour by investing heavily in sewage system improvements. We propose to continue this focus by allocating over $32 million throughout the next 10 years of the plan towards projects aimed at eliminating wet weather sewage spills into the harbour. To encourage growth, we're proposing several things. The completion of the cycleways and walkways between the central city and Lower Harbour Bridge. The dredging and improvements of the harbour, the Huntavasa Art Centre, and the revitalisation of our town centres. We're also proposing the development of an urban park with sports fields and passive recreation spaces for activities such as social events, picnics, and children's playgrounds. We play a critical role in providing the environment, infrastructure, facilities and amenities that support a high growth, high wage economy through major attractions like the Huntavasa Art Centre, attract investment to our district and encourage positive perceptions. We make decisions on your behalf and we need your guidance when deciding what actions to take. So please take the opportunity to make a submission and let us know your opinion.